know where these are and map them and help people find them. And they are substantial places. So there will be criteria for this extra location, will there? And how is that criteria established?
We do have the money to match fund the changing places. So it does rest with ourselves, obviously, to make sure that we can actually service those facilities. So we're just literally, you can say, we use the national map. You know, we try and sort of plug those gaps. So that would have to be worked in. You know, if Thornton have, it's we haven't actually named another site, but we can actually do that. We can do that through the
Yes. So that's as a separate issue for changing places. We would like that to come back to a future committee on how you work with all of those groups specifically to make sure they have good coverage in all the places that they like to visit frequently of the changing places of the village. And we'll just go back to the recommendations that we had in front of us. So the Tourism Communities Cultural National Committee is recommended to note the outcomes of the online public consultation through the Have Your Say consultation report at Appendix 1. Is everybody happy to note the public consultation, even though you in principle feel that it's putting them after the fact the recommendation to approve the closure of public towards the Morton Cross West Gaby Concourse and Mel's Parade. Now Mel's Parade Bennett's Lane, I believe, is in pretty poor state, isn't it? That's one that could definitely progress quite rapidly for an EOI. And I want to exclude Morton from that and put that into a separate recommendation. So are we happy to approve the closure of public toilets at Morton Cross, West Kirby Concourse, Mel's Parade and New Ferry as per the original recommendation excluding Morton Hough?
No.
Okay, I haven't proposed it yet, I'm still proposing on that. And then approve the public toilets identified for closure and that is to regenerate, direct relocation instead of other options for the site. So that's dependent on the previous one anyway. So I'm happy to move the recommendation with the amendments that I've just suggested. And I have a seconder, thank you, Councillor Collins. Does anybody want greater clarity on?
Yes, yes.
Yes, so it's dependent on number two, but then I do want it fast tracked for EOIs whilst we're trying to keep it open because office has to find a way in the interim until and then we have another round of budgets, budget workshops anyway. But I want to just take thoughts on how to number two. So with thoughts on have removed from the recommendations, I'm happy to propose them. Councillor Collins has been happy to second them. So in addition,
I will request two and three chair.
So it's all of recommendations 1, 2 and 3.
So you're removing Portsmouth?
Just removing Portsmouth out of these to then come back to additional.
Yeah, from paragraph 2 and paragraph 3.
Yes, because paragraph 3 dependent on it, which is, yeah, legal just qualified that, yeah. So then just to add to this, recommendation 4, officers work towards a solution where the toilets and Portsmouth are available while sports teams are using the green and to be open at weekends as the facilities of the community cafe are available. It's not available. So, in addition, I would like to see these sites prioritised with expressions of interest which are received whilst they were not in scope and are rapidly progressed following policy resources consideration of the asset strategy. So, item number 4, we're all happy with how that sounds. That's part of the same thing. I'd like to propose that. Your seconder is Councillor Collins. Do we agree? Do I assent on that one? Thank you. Thanks, everyone. That did take a little bit longer than we thought. But I agree, Councillor Ray, that it's very important that when officers are tasked with these, that they do come to the right committee and the consultation is comprehensive. Because, yeah, it's a loss of the meeting. So I do appreciate what you're making. Just gone past 7:30, and we have the PSA transfer as item number 8. This is an item, sorry, thank you, Jeanette. This item does involve some papers that you've seen in your packet or exempt. So we can proceed on this item number 8 if you feel you don't need to reference those exempt papers, otherwise I'll have to move the exemption. happy that they would be able to have this debate in for it public and not have to move the exemption, because I don't want to have to move it part way through when you start referring to exempt papers. So do we all broadly agree with that? Okay, and I think we have had one thank you to the Green Group for pre-circulating. Mary Gray very set a good precedent when she did this, and thank you for circulating your amendment. If there are any other amendments, we need them circulated now, so I propose a small comfort break before we move on to item number 8. But literally only 5 minutes for any other groups to circulate any amendments they have, and anybody to quickly pop out if they need to. Is that okay? Okay, we'll just adjourn for 5 minutes. Sorry, David, you stepped forward. Sorry.
It's just to seek some clarification, Chair. Is the expectation of the committee that the Thornton of College will reopen in the interim, or because they're currently closed?
Sorry, on the last agenda item.
Yeah.
So they're currently closed, and thank you for opening them for the Jubilee celebrations. That was really appreciated. But also, I was able to see that the condition isn't too bad at all. I know there is a huge asset piece coming, so I expect this to be happening anyway. But we've just started another big football season, and we've got young men, and you know, if it was young girls, they would want changing facilities, but as the young women start playing. So we've got young men, thankfully they're not having to turn up in a car and hop out of one set of trousers to a pair of shorts, because that was a worry during COVID when these facilities weren't available. But it's 30 people, and it's 30 people we know are coming regularly, and it's 30 people part of the league that pay into. So it was, if we could just find a solution for to work with the clubs and work with the football associations that play on Fortinoff, if we could come to an arrangement with them around the weekends when the community cafe isn't open, but also if they do have to, if they can't play on a Sunday because you can't on the fixture list, you know, make it happen, they then play on a Wednesday or Thursday. So it would just be that 30 people do need some toilet facilities when they're playing a physical game.
Yeah, sorry, Chair, not in the way. I think there are three things in here. First of all, the toilets were closed as part of the others because Jeanette has clearly got £50,000 smaller budget, and then she had to come with a proposal. Because I still involve myself in these things, or metal, I'm not quite sure which. I did get involved. We did get a plea to open them for one day because of the Jubilee event, which had been long planning. We did that. I did write to the group, the Friends group, after that, and say we would be more than happy to transfer the toilets to the little cost or whatever. They didn't reply to that. I don't know if they're still thinking it through. Jeanette and I were also assured in the pavilion for the toilets, which are used by the football groups and so on, and that we would try and work with our leisure colleagues to see if they could be used by the general public as well. I just didn't want the meeting to think that toilets are currently open because they couldn't be closed. There is an offer to the group to say, do you want them? This was pre the asset strategy. It's still there. I'm sure David and Jeanette will work through that. It's just to make sure that people know exactly where we are.
Okay, well, just to mitigate the potential impact on the saving option, I thought the officers could look at the funds we receive for hiring facilities that, we're going to get a lot of income when we build 3G pitches for a beautiful pavilion. I think the pavilion was something like nearly £1 million, the pavilion, it's right. So there's going to be these beautiful facilities coming on stream as soon as we can, and that's fabulous work by Andy and his team. So just until they're on stream, could we work with the football club? Now, the expressions of interest, I believe there was an expression of interest, but because of the limitations on the CAT policy around not-for-profit, that expression of interest couldn't progress anyway under the current CAT process. But the full asset strategy would be going to PNR, as I understand. And so that is still a site that I know if I ask you to keep it open, it will come back.